Hi, you're watching this because you've just gotten your license, which is great, but it also means danger. Your life has just become a little bit more serious. What you're about to see is the story of three young people who had just gotten their license. Some of it is disturbing. All of it is true. Their names are Nick, Crane, and Carl. This is a message from them.
I was at a party once at a friend's 18th and had a little bit too much to drink. And I went back to a friend's place and a friend asked for a lift home. My mate gave me the keys to his car. And I dropped my friend off and decided to go for a drive through my old school. Then took a corner too fast and come off the side of the road. And next thing I know, I've woke up in the middle of the bush and it's about 7 o'clock in the morning. Probably had my accident about maybe 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, so I'd been there for a while, and then I got airlifted out at about lunchtime after the police and ambulance and friends came and found me. I'm a T4, complete paraplegic. At my level, T4, that's just below your nipples. And that continues around the back at the same level as well, so because I'm complete, it's like loss of all motor and sensory function below that. So that includes sexual function, bowels, bladder. I'll never be able to walk unaided again. And I just made the wrong choice. And it's cost me a lot. I didn't think that there'd be a problem. I couldn't. Obviously, I had a fair bit to drink, so that affected my judgment a lot. And for some reason, I just decided to go for a drive. I was more worried about getting caught than for my safety. A whole range of thoughts, just not knowing what you're gonna do for the future, like, because your whole future plans just get rearranged and you have to sort them out. But you see things that you used to be able to do and places that you used to be able to go. Going down the beach, jogging, skateboarding. But I'd say independence is the biggest sort of thing that you lose and you miss the most. Like, you do wake up in the morning and just think, oh, can't sort of walk away. The chair's still there. You're not invincible, especially when you've had a lot to drink. Probably not as experienced as what you really think. You just don't realise how much your life can change in a split second, in one decision. Getting in the car, that's the biggest one. Like, if I hadn't made that choice, it wouldn't have led to the other choices. If I had a crash while my friend was in the car while I was dropping him home, which would have been devastated if anything happened to him. So pretty much from that choice of getting in the car, taking the keys, is my biggest regret.
As far as we know, he's hit his head on the windscreen, flipped up over the car, and landed behind the car.
We thought he died. Didn't we? But she just explained that he'd had a severe head injury.
I don't remember anything from the crash. I can't even remember getting hit. I think that's a good thing in a way, because all the traumatization, all the pain I went through.
Not for a long time after the crash did I stop and think about it, but now I do.
She just cares so much.
And the lady took us in that room, and we just sat there and we prayed and prayed and prayed that he'd be all right. And the doctor told us what he was going to do to Crane. I remember that as plain as day, just begging him not to let him die. Do whatever he had to do, but don't let him die.
Just put yourself in my shoes. You don't want to be here.
Yeah, as far as we know, Crane was in a coma for about 12 to 14 weeks before he fully woke up. We found out quite a bit when Crane was in hospital in his coma, and his mates all used to come up and see him. They used to dob him in what he used to do that we didn't know.
I used to play the guitar before my accident. Now I can't play because my hand's not strong enough. Just thought, why me? And got really suicidal.
He used to coach a football, under-11s football team. That was the year before. Crane was so lively. Everybody's nightmare because he used to do practical jokes on them all the time.
If am I ever going to get my life straight back to normal? I don't think I'll be able to do physical stuff like work. Where I used to work, I used to do lots of strong physical work. I don't think I'll be able to do that again. Now, it's just an imposition you don't want to be. You just want to get everything right. Back to the way you had things before.
Crane's the same person, and I get very, very cranky because he's him. It's not catching. I really do think that they think it's going to catch.
When we say to Crane, why don't your mates come and pick it, you know? Why don't they come and pick you up? Crane says, oh, would you want to take a cripple out?
We thought we were safe, that
nothing could ever happen.
Have always been good kids, done the right thing, and we never, ever, ever thought that we'd be in this position. We're just normal people, and it happened to us. It didn't only happen to Crane, it happened to all of us. Think about that crash every single day without fail. That crash has changed a lot of things.
Just hope I can get back to normal.
For the lucky stuff to we all just sat around, had a couple more drinks, and Carl was just going around, talking to everyone, having a few more wrestles with different people. Pretty much just being Carl, having a good time.
But that night, he just gave us all kisses on the cheeks, all the girls, and was just the most happiest person.
Everyone here will know he's the life of the party, just always the fun one.
The next thing I see is a sheet going over him, and that's probably the thing that just keeps playing in my mind all the time, is just this sheet going over my best mate.
To see your child's lifeless body lying on the road is just like the ultimate sense of helplessness. There's nothing you can do because it's already been done. And I just remember thinking, like, I saw his face and I just remember thinking how he can't speak to me, he can't hear me, he can't see me, he can't touch me. I'll just never hear him call out my name again, Mum.
After he died, I did take it pretty hard for quite a while. Things are just slowly starting to get better. We've been making all little steps, like had his 18th for him in memory of him. Like that was a big step for me in getting over things. But I think it'll still affect us all the way through our lives.
His smile, his eyes, his laugh, everything.
I cried for a long time. I still do. It hurts. I just miss him so much.
Like a song will come on, and like all of us, our heads will just drop. And we'll come over and support each other.
And the funeral was bad too. That was pretty bad.
I just didn't think something like this could have happened to me. There's so many questions I want to ask him and stuff I want to talk to him about. But I can't. I just want to see him and give him a bigger hug. Tell him I love him. I just don't want anything like it to happen again. I just want to see, I wait to see him again. I wait for him to walk in the house. But he never does.
I wait for him to come home, the same as what Clifford does. Not for a conversation, but just to know that he's here with the family. Because that's the way we were before he died.
The numb feeling went away, and then the feeling of knowing that he's never, ever, ever going to be coming back set in.
As far as I'm concerned, he'll never be dead as long as I'm alive. And I'll always say that. Because there's too many memories there.
I was out at the cemetery yesterday looking at his plaque that's just been put on his grave, and I just remember thinking this time last year he was down at school, he's having a ball, and now I'm out at the cemetery putting flowers on his grave.
This brings us to the end. My name is Candace Dunn, and I'm Carl's sister. I miss my little brother so dearly. I know he'd feel terrible about how his death has affected his family and friends. Please be careful when you're driving and any time you're in a car or just around cars. It's not just for your own sake, but it's for everyone who loves you. Thank you for watching.